Reinhardt today. What was his SR at? It doesn't say his SR, but 2500 game. He's probably around 2500. I'm not getting any sound. We are not getting any hint sound. Put on some tunes. And here we go. So let's see how he plays Reinhardt. Also, it looks like he's playing on whatever has the triangle. That's PlayStation? I know it has a Y button.
My genius is finally recognized.
Okay. You are holding down your shield button. That's pretty good. That's a good way to play Reinhardt. And it probably would have been better to just shoot down this angle with the fire strike instead of going for like a hit up there. Alright, you lost the sim. This is where things get a little tricky. Oh, this is the problem with tanks. You need... Okay, there you go. You guys get one pick. Okay, okay. You're not doing terrible here. I don't mind some of these pokes now that you've seen their lineup. Okay, you got a couple. Your team got a couple kills. Oh, they got a fucking Mercy. Shield. So I noticed, I mean, you are healing your shield. But don't die. Aw, shit. Get her! Okay, this time I would stop worrying about these guys behind you and get back to the choke point. There always comes this point where you...
My genius is finally recognized.
Essentially, you know your team has a numbers advantage. And as a Reinhardt, you're just going to run around swinging your hammer a little bit. It's better to put time here and block off the choke again. And what that does is it essentially cuts off reinforcements to whoever's running around back here all willy-nilly. If you don't put up a block here, what happens is while your team's distracted with this one guy, someone, like, they have a Hanzo. I mean, they could possibly get shot, right? Killed right away. So remember to divide your resources appropriately. And if you can see your team, it's like a 5-on-1 on point. Fuck it. Don't go back up. Don't go back there. Just... let your 5 handle the 1, and you can handle the front. Alright, you get your ult. Letting your shield charge up a little bit. There's a lot of fire going at your Widow. You should probably help her out now. So one style of Reinhardt before you even ult, essentially, as a team jumps in, we'll do blue. That's when you strike. You can either strike beforehand, or you can let a couple people go by, and then jump in between the ranks and hit them there. I'm curious of what you're going to try to do with your ult. That is a fucking irritating song. Still, but I can't handle silence. Oh, silence is rough. There we go. Okay, okay. This is the time when you want to ult. Okay, so don't worry what's on point. And this is when you start... as you get higher and higher up, you have to depend on your team, and I know at the lower ranks, this is actually what's very difficult, is that this D.Va will be handled by everyone else in your team. What the biggest threat here is the second attack. The second attack is the killing attack. Always remember that. Whatever they do first, fuck it. Whatever they're doing first is to set up their second attack. So what you need to do is you need to turn around 360, stun everyone. Alright. The problem is that fucking Mercy. Yep. So you're clobbering people, that's good. But you kind of wasted this choke point. So as the D.Va jump through, it's the rest of their team that's the problem. It's not the D.Va that's an issue. You needed to stun all of them and kill the Mercy. Or kill someone.
So while you respawn, we'll talk about the subs. It's Seth, and he's at 3 months. He's been here 3 months now. You made me a trap god. Thanks, fam.
Less than three. Well, thank you.
Thank you for the 3 month resub. And Killer Pantaloonies for the 4 month resub. He says resub for new emotes and the best Junkrat ever.
God damn right. Damn good emotes with some damn good Junkrat. So you're doing a little check, little third person looking around. All right. You need to be a little more accurate with your charges. I think you did get up there. You killed the soldier and the Genji. You killed the Genji while he was ulting, so definitely well worth your ult. But taking out the two DPS classes, really, like, whenever you take out a type of class on the other team, like an entire type, so you kill all of their supports or you kill all of their tanks or all of their DPS, the dynamic of the team changes drastically as compared if you only killed one of, like, one support and one damage dealer. Like, they can still kind of recover, but if you take out both of the DPS characters, you'll notice their push just lacks a lot of something.
How do you get your gameplay analyzed? There is... Oh,
my Hubris got it. Also, you need to get the fuck out of here. You fell down, but don't fall down. You gotta pick yourself back up. Yeah, get up here. Good charge. Okay, this is good. This is good. I would have liked it if you stayed up there a little bit longer. Get him. What? Did you just lag there? I think that was lag. So the problem is that you jump down for no reason. That's the second time you got that, Lucio. So whenever, and this is the truth about it all. You were on this high ground. We're looking at, like, a side view of the point. Or let's just do it this way. There's the high ground. Here's the point. Here's that other high ground. Here's the main path forward, and here's that upper balcony. You want to maintain this area. Now, you only want to get pushed off of this area when you have to get off. So the problem was is that you kind of gave it up for free, and they got this big positioning advantage on you. That's not what it looks like. Kind of like this. Don't give up your positioning advantage unless you're forced out of there. Like, you have a reason to be doing something. The first time you jumped down as Reinhardt, there was no reason to jump down. There was no one down here, so, like, nothing lost, nothing gained. They were regrouping. But on this one, they're pushing through, and you could have been up there for, like, 3-4 seconds longer and held them at this very narrow choke point. But as soon as, like, you kind of got breached, you're at, like, 350 health, you kind of just... You ran away again. For little to no reason. if you're going to give up an advantage, guys, do it for a goddamn reason. Don't just do stuff for the sake of doing it. And then you kill a mini diva. So yeah, it was lag. Alright, so Ariel confirmed it was lag. Alright, don't worry about the Winston. There's nothing you can... Okay, now you can do something about him. So this is, a division of resources. They launched the Winston up here. You can't do shit about that. But guess what? The second strike is the killing one. That's what you have to worry about. Winston... Fuck off. You can't even... Look, even if you wanted to do something, you couldn't do something because you can't get up there. So you just have to worry about this main. And as you worry about this main and you defend your team from this much damage, they can focus on this part up here better. Okay. And this is when things get messy. So I like this choice. All right. So let me go back a couple seconds just so we can talk about this. This is a big thing that people don't do, or that they do mess up. So there's people at the front, someone up here, and there's someone down low. As a Reinhardt, you can't defend from all angles, right? Your team's back here. They're up here. They're up on the balcony. I think someone was up here. What you have to do, guys, is you have to pick something. You have to pick a side, and you have to kill them. If you try to play the center and defend from everything at once, you're going to die. Now, the soldier went that way, which is great. Him and the Mercy can easily handle the D.Va. And now you can stall these guys by getting into their face, which is perfect. Look, see, soldier's handling the D.Va. And then these guys just kind of, they can't hear you. And you just start clobbering them. So that's something, like, you know, at higher levels you're not going to get away with, but the idea was good that you pressured a side. You pick something and you made a commitment to one side. It's when you're in the center. If you're in the center and you're trying to defend all three areas, you're going to get nothing. You're just going to die in the middle. You kind of have to pick a side. You have to be sub to get a sub review? No. That's why I call it user review. I call them sub reviews because that's like the known term in the Overwatch community, but it's viewer reviews. I review anyone. So, okay, I was gonna say, when you see, for two CPs especially, if you see two picks, well, there's the D.Va and there's the Genji pick below that. It usually means you can be greedy and pressure them forward, but they res. So, all right, you gotta figure your shit out again. Okay. So there you, I guess the soldier was going off. I couldn't hear, but the soldier got some TAC Pfizer kills. Just get the point. Okay, cool. Yeah, I guess that was a hard, I would have to see what you did. Or I would have to actually hear. I think you kept it, I think you kept your shield up because of the soldier ult. But you're having the same issue again where you were trying to fight too many things at once just by holding your shield up. And let's see what it is on offense. They got a Junkrat. Who picks that trash? Ugh. Worst character in the game. If it wasn't for his buffs that makes him overpowered now. But before that, he was underpowered and terrible. So, okay, I think you're doing the right thing. You can't just... You can't block all of the spam constantly, right? There's a shit ton of damage coming out. You'll definitely lose your shield, just like this. Oh, you lost a pick. So you kind of have to regroup at this point, or you can just charge in. That worked! Okay, so... It seemed really dumb. What I would say it seemed really dumb was that you lost... there is a pick beforehand. So you kind of went in 5v6. I can understand you leading with a charge. That makes sense. Kind of missed everyone. Nothing happened. But what people don't understand is that at least you fucking did something. And what happened was you ran in here. And what that caused was three people running in after you. And now that opens up for something for your team to take advantage of, which they did. So while it does seem like a stupid move, at least you did something and you caused a change. And too many people don't do this, including pros, by the way. What they don't do is on defense, especially Hanamura, this is one of the worst. Get that little area there. You got that, you got the doorway, and then you got this room. So the problem is the defense has, we'll make them orange, is they have six people. Let's just say this. And they got a shield. Now the thing is for your team, is that you have six people as well. We'll just put you up here as well. Now, because of how choke points work and the positioning advantage of defense, they're going to have six people attacking your shield constantly, right? All of this is just right on the shield. So the truth is the first thing about choke points is you kind of have to push through it. The defense has the positional advantage and the choke point advantage. And by positional, I mean, like, their formation is set up. These five guys, like, they want to be set up this way. You don't want to be set up this way, right? It's just not efficient. So they're going to be putting all six people attacking the one shield. Well, you kind of got, like, three or four attacking the one shield. The truth is, what you have to do is just fuck up their formation. You have to do anything. Anything you can do, and which is what you did. You came in here. Oh, let me do red. You busted in here and then ran this way. Which is great, because all of a sudden they took three guys and went this way. Now all of a sudden, there's only three people looking at the choke point, and you have a 5v3. Perfect. That's great. That's what you want to do is you push through this. Like, you have to... Something has to be done to mess with the formation. I call it stirring the pot. Yeah, you just have to get... You have to do something to shake things up. If you allow the defense to defend as they want, you're never going to get through. And so sometimes you have to rush through and die, and people be like, that was stupid, that was a waste, you weren't with your team. But you don't understand. What I'll do on this map is I'll run to the right, and I'll go in the stairwell and fuck around here. And if I pull two or three people, all of a sudden it's a 5v3, 5v4, which is a shit ton easier than a 6v6 on this choke point, because they have the advantage. So notice how open this choke point now is because of what you did. Now everyone will say, oh, the Reinhardt actually didn't do anything. No, you opened up this choke point by charging through it before, and they didn't allocate resources properly, so it allowed your team to get in. So the reason why this is free, it's all you. This is good, you get on point. Oh shit! Oh, you got someone. I was gonna say I don't have to tell you what you did wrong there, but hey, you actually got someone. You're making it back. Your team's got the point. Cool. Now you get to attack the second point. Let's see what he does. And it's cool you defending here just to get your team up into the corner, right? Alright, your Pharah dove way too deep. She got out a soldier ult, but I wouldn't even go up here. Your team's not with you. Where the fuck is your team? I would protect them, shield. Oh, Zenyatta's. So this is one of those times where you have to... A common question I get is, hey Crow, should I stay in position if my team's not there? Or if my team is out of position, should I be with them? The truth is, in Overwatch, if it's better to do something stupid together than do something smart alone. So your Zen wanted to fight there, fuck, you kind of needed to protect him. Okay. So... Your team was not with you at all. I mean, yes, that stirred the pot for sure. You did have a Mercy, so you can do something stupid. And they got your healer. Symmetra's still going ham on point. I would actually try... Oh, man. What a shitty spot. Your team's flanking so heavy that, like, I want to say you should leave this area to get with the rest of your team. But half of your team is fucking over here. Also, like I said, your ult before was just... There was no follow-up on it from your teammates. You kind of needed them to be with you. Yeah, your teammates just weren't with you. So what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to block more, which is going to allow your teammates to get on point, and then you can ult from there. This is a soldier, right? Oh, it's a Junkrat. There you go, start using that shield. So you have to regroup. You just lost two people. If you lose anyone before a push on a 2CP map, it's just dead. You can't do it. Okay. There you go. Now you're using the shield. So push it. So you have to make a decision. And as the Reinhardt, you're the first one. You have to be the first one through the door. If you jump back, your entire team jumps back. You have to remember that you are the Vanguard. You will be the first in to do something. Keep the shield up. Keep your shield up. Okay, now your team's taking advantage of it. You're running a Symmetra and she's setting up in this area. That was a good ult on their D.Va's part. And remember, you only have to shield for the last second. You're saying the team wouldn't group up. So it doesn't matter if the Sim was in chat or not. You have to make an area easier for her to get to. So this is good. Look, you're in here, you're taking up space. Your shield's going down very, very slowly. You're going to be fine. Oh, I think that was a, okay. They still got a shield up. Careful. Okay, that was good. So, I mean, it's not, you're not doing terrible. But it's just a difficult... The Mercy's hiding in the back. She's probably in spawn. Both, like, if you try to just go through the entryway, it has some extra turrets. So I don't know if there was a call out to jump on point, but you kind of just jumped on point, which isn't bad. But as long as, again, you had the high ground, you shouldn't drop down on the low ground unless your team gets a pick or unless your team jumps down there. And that was just overzealous. I know you're running out of time, but you rushed that one. And I know your eyes got big because you're like, look, there's three people in a hallway. I'll kill all of them. That's not how Reinhardt's charge works. Sometimes everyone gets away for no reason. Why doesn't he combo with other things like with charge? Alright. So, it is a good point. Let's get blue here. We're gonna use red. Correcting color. So, for Reinhardt. I mean, the fire strikes. The way I say it is go for probability. Or the highest chance percent to hit. So a couple times you're like trying to like shoot a guy that was jumping over here. Or there's a nice big ass choke point you could have hit like five people with. Yeah, you could have killed a guy maybe and you could help someone on your team like from far away. But the truth is, you need to build alt with that Reinhardt charge, or the Reinhardt fire blast. Go for chance to hit. Also, your accuracy on is a little low. I think you're using your hammer enough. Yeah, I want to say you're overusing it. I think it was fine where it was at. Your charge, though, you got your charge a decent couple of times, but that last attack. Yeah, you kind of missed it. You're trying to charge too much. You're trying to get too much done. Remember, you gotta have some faith in your teammates as a tank. It's just how the game works right now. It means don't try to do everything by yourself because tanks are heavily position based. Also, yeah, the guy in chat even commented on it. He's like, man, he doesn't charge after an ult. Which is like, essentially secures one kill. Your ults... Your DPS was what? It was Tracer Pharah. Yeah, so... This has to do with this. And I know I tell a lot of people this. Where's your team? I didn't have any sound, so I couldn't tell if you could hear them behind you or if they talked to you and said, hey, I'm behind them. But I'd say I think three or four of your alts had no follow-up. And I don't know if there's a miscommunication with you and your team or you just thought it was a different scenario that was playing out in your head. But there was multiple upon multiple times where you just kind of alted. And the thing about Reinhardt ult is, yeah, he can probably get a kill, maybe two, depending how close he is. But if you're ulting someone that's 10, 15, 20 meters away, you don't have to follow up on it. You need your team there for it. It's a team-based ult. If your team's not there, it's a waste. It'd be better to die and have it than to waste it. Logistically, I guess it would be position that I want to look at. Don't give up high ground. Not even high ground. Don't give up an advantage. That should be a G. Oh, it's a G with a sweet haircut.
My genius is finally recognized.
Okay, that's really poorly written, but it says don't give up an advantage without reason. So many times you were on the high ground or you had some significant positional advantage and you're just like, ah, I'm just going to jump on the low ground. Or you're like, oh, Winston zapped me for 100 health. I'm going to run away and go to the low ground. Whenever you have the advantage in Overwatch or in anything else, do not give it up unless you got a goddamn reason. Don't do something stupid or do something like drastic just because. It's an advantage for a reason, so use it. You have to leverage it. Make someone work for it to get you out of that spot. Multiple times you just kept on jumping down to the low ground for no reason. It happened 2 or 3 times on defense, and it happened, I think, twice on offense. So yeah, just be wary of that. It's completely okay for you to attack as a Reinhardt. Take that high ground, sit up there for 10, 20 seconds until your team gets a pick, and then you can jump down. Or if your team just decides to jump down, then hey, you got to do it, right? But don't give up that advantage without a reason. Logistics. This is like skill usage and getting to where you need to get to. That was fine. So as a Reinhardt, just you have to defend people to get to where you want to get to. So in that map, Hanamura, when you're attacking, like you go up that staircase, you're outside, then you go in there, and you go up that next staircase. Looks something like that. There's that nice long covered pathway. There's that stairway. Large health pack is here. There's the next stairway. It takes you to the high ground. So essentially, what you want to do, what I consider logistics, is like you're shielding here so everyone can get to this spot safely. Once you're outside this choke point, then you shield your way up here so everyone can get to this point safely. And then you shield right here while you're looking down in the flag room. And that's when you can start like committing resources to killing people and whatnot. That's logistics. Your other skill usage, you weren't charging. You charged a couple times with alt, but not often. I think it's because you charged into battle with it, and you'd alt, and then you just wouldn't have it again. Fire strike, we talked about that. Yeah, those were the big things I saw with your review. Along with all the like the combat theory I talked about in the video. So you know, like when someone jumps in. If you got a choke point and one person runs in, fucking let him. You go over here and you cut off his reinforcements, and then you let your 5 teammates kill this one guy. And then he'll die. And then you kept their reinforcements back, so it really helps you. Yeah, that was your problem on defense. I think 2 or 3 times. Actually, I think every single time. That's what you did. Someone got behind you and you just ran at them. It reminds me of little kids playing soccer. If anyone knows what happens when little kids play soccer, is that the soccer ball goes over here, and then you have 11 players on this side and 11 players on this side, and they all just run towards the ball because they all think they're supposed to be doing that. Like, no. Some of you guys got to play defense. All right? You guys got to stay back here and play defense. So this guy has to play goalie. You can't just run at the ball, too. So when someone runs through the choke point, don't just run at them. I think that is it. The area you're in chat. you have any questions?
Stop judging your soccer play style. Well, groans, start playing soccer like an adult. Basically, Lucio Ball. That's a good one. Telefron, right? He hosted me. And Livolska with the tier one sub. New guy, new crony, new emotes. Thank you for the subscription, my friend. Welcome to the team. Any questions?
Well, you're not typing fast enough, so your question is null and void.
What alts don't require team acknowledgement to be advantageous?
Well, I mean, if someone knows what you're doing, it usually helps. But most of the DPS alts don't need to be like told beforehand. It definitely helps, but like when you just kill someone straight out, right, that usually is good. It's a lot of tank-based alts that disable, they stun, they do something, they push enemies back. Stuff that you need to follow through on. It helps a lot.
How's your shield usage?
I think your shield usage was fine. There's just a couple times when you're stuck in the middle, like you're trying to defend three flanks, and then you had to pick a side to defend from. I think your shield usage was fine.
So with that, let's switch over to the next review because we kind of got a lot of shit to go through.